Hello everyone, this is Connie Jo with Soul Navigation, and if you found this channel, these messages wanted to find you. So we have a brand new show called Spirit Talk with Team Soul Navigation, where every day you'll receive horoscopes, tarot predictions, divine messages, and communication from your spirit guides. All from one of us here at Team Soul Navigation. So tune in every day for messages just for you from one of the members of Team Soul Navigation. So I am Connie Jo, and I'm a psychic, I'm an astrologer, and I'm a tarot reader. And I'm so happy to be here today to bring you your love fortune cookies for the week of November 2nd. So let's get started and crack open some cookies. So hello, Aries. Things are looking up for you this week. Mercury is turning direct in your seventh house. And the Gemini moon is lighting up your communication sector. So this will make socializing easier for you if you're in a relationship. It'd be a great week to plan some romance and fun. All of those mixed signals and miscommunications and Mercury retrograde issues, you can put those in the past. Time to move past all of that, right? So going into the weekend, Aries, the Leo moon is trine your sign in your fifth house of romance. Woohoo! You'll be at your very best, Aries. And how could anyone say no to you? It'll be a great week. And it will absolutely be a great weekend. So plan something fun and get out there and show your stuff. So, Taurus. You'll feel more like socializing at the beginning of the week. Mercury's going direct. The Gemini sun, moon is shining in your second house. And if getting out and about doesn't quite feel like, plan a romantic dinner for two. A movie. Definitely some cuddling time. In the middle of the week, as the moon moves into Cancer, making a positive aspect to your sign, the romance heats up. And in your third house, so it might be a great time for a short, sexy trip together. Doesn't that sound fun? Or if you're single and looking, spend some time with siblings and neighbors. They might introduce you to that special someone. Or you might meet someone fantastic while you're walking the dog. Keep your options open, Taurus, because this will be a good week for you if you just stay open and be ready for anything. So please comment below if any of this relates to you. And by the way, become a Soul Navigation Super Supporter. You can read more about it in the notes below. And the supporters get in on all of the Soul Navigation juiciest astrology secrets. So make plans to join. It'll be worth it for you. Hello, Gemini. Look for a great start to your week. The Gemini moon is shining in your first house, and you will be the life of the party. Aren't you usually the life of the party? Well, you definitely will be this week. Okay, so with the moon making a trine to Venus, you'll be attracting attention everywhere you go. So get ready for some romance. So you'll have a break when the moon moves into Cancer in the middle of the week. So, Maybe time for a sexy midweek dinner at home. Maybe leave the party behind for a minute. But you won't get any rest for long because the Leo moon is moving into your social communication sector for the end of the week and you will be at your Gemini best. So get ready to make some moves and accept some offers, Gemini. They're coming your way. Hey everybody, don't forget, listen to your moon sign and your Venus sign and Mars sign as well. They will all give you so much information and just put it all together and they'll give you a wonderful picture of what your week can look like, you know? Hey, Cancer! Hooray! Mercury is moving direct in your fourth house. And any tension you were feeling on the home front is going to start to ease up this week. Thank goodness, huh? So romance is back in the picture. And the moon that rules your sign will be moving into Cancer in the middle of the week. So you're going to be feeling it. You're going to be feeling great. So it's a time to fix yourself up and enjoy the moonlight. So people will be drawn to you this week like a moth to a flame. So if you're looking for love, you might not have to look far. That special someone could show up seemingly out of nowhere. It's all good with that Cancer moon in your sign, so get ready for that one. Leave a comment below, Cancer. I'd love to hear how this week turns out for you. So, hi, Leo! Mercury's going direct, and it couldn't come at a better time. To start the week off, the Gemini moon will be in your 11th house of friends and organizations, wishes, hopes, dreams, and you'll be definitely ready to socialize. So, go out and have a good time with your friends. If you're single, a good friend might introduce you to that someone special, or maybe a friend might become that someone special. You never can tell, right? The Leo moon will be shining on you this weekend. And I predict you're going to be feeling great. Hey, Leos, it is time to roar. Get ready for that weekend, Leo moon. I think you're going to enjoy it. Hey, everybody. Stay tuned till the end of the video. I've got a great contest. You can win a free 30-minute reading with one of the fantastic soul navigation readers. So they can do anything. They are awesome mediums, astrologers, tarot readers, energy healers. We've got it all. So wait to the end of the video and I'll tell you how you can be part of that drawing. And hopefully you'll be the winner. So, hi Virgo! Your ruler Mercury is going direct and you are feeling good. Well, at least you're feeling much better. So, the Gemini moon is lighting up your 10th house. And you're ready to show yourself off this week. Enjoy the social energy of that Gemini moon. If you're attached, an intimate get-together with friends could be just what you need to get the romance going. And as the moon moves into Leo at the end of the week, make time for some alone time. If you're looking for love, it might find you at work, a cooking class, out shopping. If you're working from home, you never know when a little flirtation on the phone or the computer might happen. Keep your options open, Virgo. Don't be closed off to meeting someone when you're out shopping for groceries. People have found the love of their lives that way, you know? How are you, Libra? You should be feeling great this week. So, Mercury is going direct in your sign this week. And the planets of love and communication in your first house will make you feel at your social best. And that's what you do best, Libra. You are the socialite. So don't be shy about texting or calling that special someone that you've had your own. They won't be able to resist your charm. So the Leo moon at the end of the week, that'll have you itching to get out on the town. So, if you're able, get out there and show your stuff. If you're in a relationship, it's a great time for love and romance, even with Mars retrograde in the seventh house. So, a date night could be just what you need to light your fires. With Uranus in your eighth house, it could be a really, really big fire. Go, Libras. So, Scorpio, you still have that glorious sun shining down on you, showing your Scorpio best. At the beginning of the week, the moon, the new Gemini moon, will be in your eighth house. That Scorpio rules. So how sweet is that? Very sexy energy for you. So take advantage of it. Plan some sexy alone time, you know? And as the moon moves into Cancer in the middle of the week, it trines your sign. So the week just gets better and better for you, Scorpio. So plan that romantic time. You know, it's a great week on the love front for you. So enjoy it. And hey, if you're looking for love, just be your sexy self. And I predict it'll find you. It'll be a good week for you, Scorpio. All of you Scorpios, please leave me a comment. I'd really like to know how your week went. Hiya, Sagittarius! So, at the beginning of the week, the Gemini moon is lighting up that seventh house. It's a great time for sexy communication with your partner. So, it'd be a great week to go out and socialize together as well, you know? If you're unattached and looking, the Gemini moon invites you to have a good time. Believe me, it's all about the good time. So, you never know who you may meet at the party. And towards the end of the week, the moon moves into Cancer and your eighth house. And so romance can really heat up. So plan a romantic week. A sexy weekend as the Leo moon trines your sign. I'm thinking a good week for you, Sagittarius, especially the weekend with that Leo moon trining your sign. Enjoy yourself. You deserve it. Hey, y'all, if you love astrology and want to learn more, hit that subscribe button. Soul Navigation always has more and more to learn. Great love, great money, great everything. You can learn all about astrology on Soul Navigation. So I invite you to hit that subscribe button and check it out for yourself. So, hey Capricorn. So, you can look forward to a fun start to the week as Gemini moves into your sixth house. And it's making a great aspect to Venus. So this could put some heat into your everyday routine. And who doesn't want some heat in their everyday routine? I mean, it's your everyday routine. It'd be nice if it heated up a little bit, wouldn't it? So, expect romance with your partner as the moon moves into the Cancer in the middle of the week, and it lights up your house of committed relationships. So, if you're a single Cancer, look towards the end of the week for the moon to make its way into fun romantic Leo. The moonbeams will be shining on your eighth house, so look for some sparks to fly. The eighth house can be a very sexy house, so I'm thinking, Capricorn, that whether you're single or attached, things are going to be pretty good for you this week. So, here we go, Aquarius. Lucky you! The lovely Gemini moon will be in your house of romantic affairs to start off the week. So, it's a fantastic time, really, it is, to meet someone new and have fun. So, you'll have time to rest in the middle of the week when the Cancer moon moves into your sixth house. So, enjoy the break just for a minute, because toward the weekend, we have the moon in Leo. And if you're in a committed relationship, this is your time for romance and love. That Leo moon is going to light up your seventh house. So, the Leo moon is playful. Plan something fun. Have a good time with it. It's a time to enjoy your partner and really take advantage of that fiery energy. So, hello, Pisces. So, you can look for love in your fourth house of home as Gemini lights that up at the beginning of the week. So, it might be the most romantic place for you to be, you know? You can save the parties for the other signs and socialize with your honey alone. I promise you won't miss the party. So, it'll be party time for you when Cancer moves into your fifth house. That Cancer moon's gonna light it up in the middle of the week. So, if you are single and looking, the moon's in its home sign and in your most romantic house. Take advantage of it. Take a chance, Pisces. You know, this energy is in harmony with your sign, and I'll bet if you make the first move, the answer will be yes. Enjoy it, Pisces. Enjoy it. So, everybody, if you want a deeper look into your love life, come book a reading with me at soulnavigation.com. Right now we have introductory rates, and so everyone can afford it. And check the notes below for more info on that. And oh, I have an exciting announcement to make. So I was telling you about the free reading. So all you have to do is like, share, comment, or subscribe to get your name entered into the Soul Navigation Contest, where you can win a free 30-minute reading with one of our amazing readers. And they are all amazing, let me tell you. Each and every one of them have beautiful gifts to give to you. So, we'll draw the name and announce the winner on the 15th of each month. And we'll see you back here daily at 12 noon Pacific Standard Time with Spirit Talk with Soul Navigation. I've so enjoyed giving you your love fortune cookies for the week, and I hope you have a fantastic week ahead. It's Connie Joe. I've enjoyed it. Bye-bye.